My question is essentially, with every political thing, is what is your utopia, right? What's the world we want to live in? And I think the system you're advocating, laissez-faire capitalism, it's happened, right, in the 19th century. And that was essentially the situation where people don't had a choice, didn't have a choice between working and dying. And, you know, I think that's not the world we want to live in, and it's certainly not the world I want to live in.
That's right. Before the 19th century, the only choice they had was to die. And you want to take the choice to live from them. And that's fantastic, right? You'd prefer dead people than people who have a choice between death and life. I find that bizarre. Because before the Industrial Revolution, how many kids lived to see the age of 10? Less than 50%. What was life expectancy? 39. I get to his question, believe me, I'll answer it in detail. Yes, I'm offering them a choice to live. That's exactly what the Industrial Revolution did. It raised the standard of living of all of us. You wouldn't be here if not for laissez-faire capitalism during the 19th century. You wouldn't have any wealth to redistribute today. We'd still be living to 39. We'd still be dying when we were children. You think the Industrial Revolution created child labor? What did children do before the Industrial Revolution? They worked on farms and died working on farms. What the Industrial Revolution allowed them to do is earn enough money so they didn't have to die. Oh my God, what a horrible thing. Children living. We wouldn't want that, right? So what the 19th century did was allow us to create enough wealth so we as parents could take our children out of the workforce, because nobody wants children to work, and put them into schools. But before the end of the 19th century, before laissez-faire capitalism, before we created the wealth that laissez-faire capitalism allowed us to create, we were too poor to keep our children home. You guys should study just a little bit of history. It would be helpful. But let me talk about China, because I, counter to you guys, have been to China, have talked to those people. They love their jobs at Apple. They love their jobs at Apple because the alternative is not death. The alternative is not death. The alternative is going back to the farm and living under socialism, the system that you love so much. And that system, well, it is, because those are the two alternatives at the end of the day. And that system is horrific. That system is horrible. Now you say, why don't they just get European-style salaries? Why don't we just pay Chinese workers what we pay Europeans? Well, because China doesn't have that kind of money. It doesn't have that wealth. They're not that productive. Where's the money going to come? You guys think the money grows on trees, or the government just prints it, of course. And it just is there, right? You have to make stuff to get money. China, over the last 30 years, China, through this horrible stuff that you describe, has allowed more people to rise out of poverty than any country in human history during a 30-year period. Over 400 million people have gone from poverty into middle classhood in China. We should be celebrating this. We should be demonstrating in the streets in favor of more of this, more freedom, more capitalism, so more people can rise from poverty into middle classhood. Before capitalism, we were all poor. Suddenly, after the 19th century, we're middle class and rich. I wonder what happened in between.
Welfare state developed.
In China. China today. Go to China. Go to rural China, where there's no capitalism, where the party is still imposing its socialism. And go to Shanghai. Go to Shenzhen. Go to Guangzhou. Go to the cities in which they've allowed economic freedom. And see the wealth that they have created. See the wealth that Chinese people have created for themselves. And you want to criticize these people for the lives that they have made? Because again, you sit in middle class Europe, twiddling your thumbs in a welfare state that survives because you've got some people producing and you can steal their money and give it to others. And you've got ancestors who created massive amounts of wealth because they were free. And you sit here and you judge Chinese laborers who are choosing a much better life, learning a skill, advancing in their profession. Some of them become plant managers and ultimately entrepreneurs and build their own businesses and become rich. It's a disgrace. I mean, literally, it makes me so angry because it is a disgrace. The West is a disgrace because you want to keep them in poverty. Let me go back to the CO2. You know what would happen to the poor in Africa if you guys got your way with CO2? You would institutionalize them into poverty. They would always be poor. Because the way to rise up is to burn fuel. That's how we get energy. So if you ban oil, Africans will always be poor. But you don't care. You care more about the snails than you do about anybody living in Africa. If you cared about Africans, you would be advocate for capitalism. You would want them to burn carbon fuels. You would want them to be rich. And the only way to be rich, is to make it, produce it, create it, and that requires economic freedom, that requires burning fossil fuel, that requires property rights. That's what you should be advocating for Africa, if you really care. You don't have compassion. I have compassion. I care about Africa. I beat Africa. I beat China. You laugh all you want. I care about them, and because I care about them, I'm an advocate for capitalism. I'm not an advocate for capitalism because I want to be controversial, because I think it's funny, or I think it's cool, like you guys. I advocate for capitalism because I care about human beings and human life. I want to see us live to be 120. I want to see Africa thrive. I want to see them unbelievably productive, because you know what? If Africa's productive, I'm better off. I understand that production is win-win, that if somebody else is rich, I'm even richer. I want everybody to be rich if they can. But for that, you need freedom, you need property rights, you need to produce, you need capitalism.